I also hope that you have seen the previous videos, all the interesting experiments we have done regarding acid bases indicators and pH indicator, neutralization reaction, importance of pH. So these all were very interesting videos. If you haven't watched them, please do watch them. Okay, so in today's video, we are going to learn about family of salts. So how are salts formed? So salts are formed by reaction of acids and bases. So when an acid and a base are reacting, then they give out salt and water. So this is the basic equation. When an acid and a base are reacting, then they give out salt and water. So this one we have seen in our neutralization reaction also. So based on the different combination of acids and bases, there are few types of salts formed. So let us see them all in brief. So based on the different combinations of acids and bases, means strong acid or a strong base or a weak acid and a weak base, based on the different combinations, there are different types of salts formed. Okay, so basically we will be having three types of salts. So what are those? Acidic salts, neutral salts and basic salts. Okay, so on what combination they give out these type of salts, let us see. So first is strong acid and a strong base. So when strong acid and a strong base are reacting, they give out neutral salts and water. Okay, so let us see one example, that is sodium hydroxide is a strong base. So when it is reacting with a hydrochloric acid, which is a strong acid, then they give out neutral salt, that is sodium chloride and water. Okay, so we are saying that it is a neutral. So what will be the pH of it? It will be ranging from 5 to 7. Okay, and these neutral salts will be not conducting electricity when they are in solid state. But they do conduct electricity when they are formed as a solutions. Okay, so this is about the neutral salts. And let us see two more examples. That is sodium chloride and ammonium sulfate and magnesium sulfate. And there is one more case where the neutral salts are formed. So what is that case? Here when a weak acid and weak base are formed or reacted, then also they give out neutral salts. Okay, so let us see here. Acetic acid, when it is reacting with ammonium hydroxide, then it gives out ammonium acetate and water. Okay, so this is the neutral salt. And few other examples are potassium nitrate and calcium bromide. Okay, so in these two cases, we get the neutral salts. Then when will be the acidic salts formed? When a strong acid and weak base are reacting, then they give out acidic salts. So let us see that example. When hydrochloric acid, that is strong acid, is reacting with ammonium hydroxide, which is a weak base, then they give out ammonium chloride, which is an acidic salt, and water. Okay, and these pH will be ranging below 7. Acids, we know that they range from 0 to 7. So these acidic salts pH also will be ranging below 7. And let us see few more examples, that is ammonium chloride and aluminium sulfate and lead nitrate and ferrous sulfate and ferrous chloride. So these are the few other examples of the acidic salts. And next is when the basic salts are formed. So by this you might have known that when the basic salts will be formed. When a weak acid and a strong base are reacting, then they give out basic salts. Okay, so here this is the one of the example where acetic acid, which is a weak acid, is reacting with sodium hydroxide, which is a strong base. Then it is giving out ammonium acetate and water. And there are few other examples, calcium carbonate and potassium cyanide and sodium sulfide. So these are also other kinds of basic salts. So as I am saying, it is a basic, so you can guess the pH. It will be obviously greater than 7. These were the different kinds of salts we have seen, and let us see few more other types of salts, and let us see how they are useful in our daily life. So these are the different types of salts which we use in our daily lives. So the most commonly used salt is common salt. Okay, so that common salt is also called as sodium chloride or table salt. Okay, so when that sodium chloride is in a solution form, we call it as a brine solution. Okay, and this sodium chloride is used for enhancing the taste. We generally use this common salt in our food, yes or no? So that enhances the taste of the food, and it is also used as the antiseptic. And here, this is a basic for preparing the other salts. So how are the other salts prepared by using this common salt? When the brine solution is subjected to electrolysis process, then what happens is the sodium hydroxide will be left over as a solution, and chlorine will be collected at the anode, and hydrogen gas will be collected at the cathode. So this chlorine gas, when it is subjected to different types of products, then they give out different types of salts. So like that, we have many examples. Let us see one by one. And the most commonly used, bleaching powder. Okay, so you might have heard this word, bleaching powder. So that chemical formula is CaOCl2. Okay, so how is it formed? When calcium hydroxide, when it is subjected to the chlorine evolved from the brine solution, then the bleaching powder is formed by evolving the water from it. And the uses of bleaching powder are, it is used in textile industry, it is used in paper industry for whitening the surface of the products. Now for textile or paper also, for whitening purposes, they will be using the bleaching powder. And for the cleaning purpose, so generally for cleaning the washrooms or any other swimming pools or anything, so they will be using this bleaching powder so that the stinky smell will be removing. So that's what is the uses of the bleaching powder. And next, it is also used as a disinfectant, and it is also used in the manufacturing of chloroform. Okay, so this is the one type of the salt we have seen. So other two types of salts are also there. So the another is baking soda. Baking soda chemical formula is NaHCO3. It is also called as sodium hydrogen carbonate. So how is it formed? When the sodium chloride, it is reacting with water, carbon dioxide and ammonium, then it gives out ammonium chloride and sodium hydrogen carbonate. Okay, so when, so here this is another type of salt, that is nothing but baking soda. So baking soda chemical formula is NaHCO3. We also say it as sodium hydrogen carbonate. So when is it formed? When sodium chloride is reacting with water, carbon dioxide and ammonium, then it gives out ammonium chloride and sodium hydrogen carbonate. And then where are we using these all baking soda? So here the sodium hydrogen carbonate is used for many purposes. So first is in cooking purpose, for preparing the cakes or anything, they'll be using this baking soda so that the puffy cakes will be prepared. And it is also used in the antacids. So we know that antacids tablets are taken to neutralize the acidity level. So that's why they'll be using this baking soda in that antacid tablets. And it is used in the fire extinguisher. So here directly they don't use the sodium hydrogen carbonate. They'll be using the soda water. So that soda water also will be used as a fire extinguisher. And it is also used in the antiseptic creams. Okay, so the next is washing soda. So that washing soda is prepared from the baking soda. So that baking soda, when it is further heated, then it gives out sodium carbonate, water and carbon dioxide. And when that sodium carbonate is reacted with 10 moles of water, then it gives out sodium carbonate with 10 moles of water, which is nothing but your washing soda. Okay, so here you might be thinking that how that 10 moles of water? Here we are calculating per molecular level. But if you are taking in a whole sum, then it will be some liters or anything. Means the ratio is 1 is to 10. If the sodium carbonate is 1, then 10 times is the water level in it. So that's what we say. We take it as a sodium carbonate 10 moles of water. Okay, so here the sodium carbonate will be using for washing purpose, because we generally washing soda is nothing but your surf. Okay, so that surf will be using for washing purpose and manufacturing of borax powder and removing the hardness of water. So these are the different kinds of salts we have seen. So I hope you have understood this video very well, and if you have any doubts regarding this topic, you can comment me in my comment section, and more interesting videos are yet to come. So till then, keep observing and keep learning. Thank you.